try to have some more content. As you have, may have noticed, I borrowed the title from Kave, and I will try to answer it actually. So it starts with why tech, and our predecessor Kave and Karel has, and many others has already coped with this. Why tech mass? It's also has been talked about. Ross, Rishi, and others convince us that tech mass is the selling point of our tools and tech, and the compact logical expression notation tech offered is now used throughout the world, and it's liked by any mathematicians you may think of. So formula is worth of hundreds of words, and tech mass wins here. But why tech mass search? Well, nobody has mentioned it here, and it's badly needed, however. Searching is a crucial part of accessibility. When you have lots of your PDFs and you want to access it, the most natural and usual way is to search it. And this is no different for mathematics. Why should it? So my honest opinion is that tech mass search is really a must for when working with lots of data and working with digital library of mathematics, which is actually the project I'm now involved in. You see the logo below, and in frame of it, we have thought a little more about it and try to answer the question of the title. Well, one possible answer is because of the of GS in Google and globalization, and it's sexy, right? So we have about 100 million pages of peer-reviewed mathematics around, and the ambition is to search it. It fits on the disk of your notebook, and why on earth we shouldn't be able to search it even with formula in it? And well, that's the tasks we were thinking about, and the gate to this knowledge is search. A digital library without mathematical search is an oxymoron. For pure text and keyword-based search, it's a solved problem. You use Google every day, and it's supported by review databases like Centralblatt, so one can say it's success. However, have you tried to search some formula on Google or in other system? There are not many systems that allow it, so I would qualify that it's failure so far. So what we can do with that? It's to support that's needed. I've come up with some examples. Adding ability to search for formulas in textual search may actually disambiguate and narrow your documents and narrow the search so that you actually find what you are looking for. And sometimes the only difference that you can use is actually the formula. So, for instance, it's possible that Kaveh might be looking for some data for his talk in the whole River Valley database of all types of articles ever, which might be about, my rough estimate is 5 number digit. I have talked to VTech people, they said they have around 40 or 50,000 articles with done with TeX, and one could search that all within microseconds, even with formulas. I have another real examples. Researcher might be working in some area of differential equations, and the types of the equation might be differentiated by the formula. So putting a formula in the search is crucial for she or he. And language of mathematics is actually the same with some exceptions for all the natural languages. So having global search, let's say on Google, one can use formulas to search all over the languages, and the differences in notations are there, but it might be coped with as such. So our topic of this conference is ebook. Imagine your on your iPad or examples of statistic book, imagine that you may search in it, because you usually use it for reference purposes only. Imagine that you can search the formula you remember and want to look for. So the takeoff message of this talk is yes, you actually can, and we have tried that and we have done that, and I will just show you, and if time permits I will then make explanation what to do and how it was done. So giving Google a question like Einstein, Czech Google actually does the answer pizza Einstein, which is not relevant usually what you are looking for. Well, what our system actually does? So when you So when you put the query Einstein and his formula in your search box and you press the button, which here means you search for it, it does a kind of does a lot of works. It converts it to MathML, then it converts it into canonized MathML, some canonical representation of it, and then here you are, you have the results with the search terms, including the equations, right? So here. Then you can click in and go to see the real papers here, and you end up in Cornell and read the paper with the Einstein formula other stuff in it. So, well, how is it done? It's topic for the rest of the talk, so I have 15 minutes to describe how it is done and how it works. So when we cope with this problem, we started with a review of available solutions. We spoke to Google Scholar people because we wanted to search the metadata, at least metadata of the articles on Google Scholar. And as mathematics is often even in the titles of papers, Google Scholar does a bad job in it. There were other attempts by some publishers, for instance, Springer offers LaTeX search, but it works on the text, literal texts of TechMass cut out of the of their sources, and as such, it's deemed to failure because one never knows what author has typed when writing the formula. Every formula has a zillion of ways how it can be entered and typeset, right? So this is not way to go. There are many changes to face. There is heterogeneity of mass representation, notation, the semantics handling, and there is no established and accepted user interface and query language for mass so far. And there were several attempts to solve that problem. There was 7-digit NSF grant by Design Science some 5 years ago. It was Lucene-based, essentially indexing engrams of presentation MathML. But the site is gone, it's login restricted, and even though it was pioneering effort in converting to MathML, the results are not seen. There is another project, it's EgoMass by our Prague colleagues. It's web search engine capable of handling mass. They did another step. They brought the idea of formula augmentation, alpha equivalence algorithm, and relevance calculation to solve the problem. I've already spoken about LaTeX search, reactive mass, and DLMF, digital library of mathematical functions. Our project where the mass can be searched by their domain is limited, so they are able to offer, they have the offering part under control, so they can mark up the formulas according their indexing engines. But this cannot be used in general global search. People in Bremen are using semantic approach, they use substitution trees based on, so it's not real full text search, but the problem is that you can have a reasonable amount of data disambiguated with this level of markup, semantic markup. So we have decided to build our own, taking lessons from the previous, more or less unsuccessful attempts. And we have built MIAS engine, Mass Indexer and Searcher, which is MathAware full text based search engine. It adds mathematical equation querying to the basic textual ones. So in addition to standard terms, you can have mass in the search query in the standard TeX or AMS LaTeX, to be precise, notation. So ideally, it should be directly compilable with AMS LaTeX. And then, well, you get what you are looking for. We had to cope with the duality of TeX and MathML formats. Mass is used by people, and here tech notation wins. So on the offering side and on the querying side, tech is the preferred way of writing and working. However, on the software application side, program side, algorithmic side, the MathML clearly wins all DTPs, all computer algebra systems allows you to copy and paste formula and derivate and integrate in another and put it into browser, etc. And some DTP systems, including KVS, are having MathML and XML at its heart. So inevitably, a system for searching math has to cope with this duality. Another idea one should think of it in retrieval is that the indexing terms and the search terms do not necessarily be the strictly same. In text retrieval, usually word stems are indexed instead of word forms. So in Czech, average word has 30 different word forms. So that may help to squeeze the index. And there are examples like in tech book, DON typesets, their example of content invitation, concert invitation, and actually there is not there is a song, but the offer of that song is not on the invitation, but it appears in the index. So it's an example that these two are not necessarily strictly same. So the same idea applies for mass search. So we have designed the search such that for a given formula we generate set of substitutes, more and more general and similar representations of formula that's put in the index and they are stored there. That's top level architecture of the system. The tech plays a role here. Together with tech or HD or Drive or whatever you may have into converting text to MathML. Then input document is taken by document handler and the text is thrown into standard indexing printing like you see. And the math takes special care. It's tokenized, processed, and special representation of the math is put into index so that the searcher then may query it. And input query takes similar processing. The templates are converted to MathML generalized and looked up in the search. More precisely, during the indexing, so that A plus B and B plus A do not have to be the same, the two items in the index. All indexing terms are first order, so that only there are lexicographically ordered, so that only A plus B appears in the index. The same happens for in the querying phase. Then it's tokenized, so the unique representation of the formulas built on. Then more generic terms are being created. Three variables are numbered and term based on that is created. And the same happens for constant. So to match as much similar formulae as possible and to have as small index as possible, big machinery takes care before the terms appear in the index. Let me show it on an example. Let's have x squared plus x up to y plus y cubed. So ordering doesn't change it. X is less than y, then the algorithms for subformally takes place, and several subformally is generated, and they are unificationized terms are created. So finally, you end up with 16 terms that are put into the index with different weights according to the similarity to the original term. During searching, the similar things happen. Two terms are generated. Four terms are generated, and two match the index. And for these two, the ranking scores are added for the documents. Here you can see more details how the weighting, that means how similar the indexed terms are to the formula. So this tree has 16 nodes, and every list has its weight, which is stored in the index too. It's built upon Lucene, latest Lucene, as a plugin written in Java, and it's state-of-the-art digital library stuff used in this space and dozens of other systems. So nothing new here, and it can be directly used in a real system. For evaluation, we have used ArcSife, converted into the XML. It's about 500,000 documents, which were converted to XML plus MathML by our Bremen colleague, Professor Kolhase, and others. At the end of the day, we had 158 million of input formulae. And with the multiplication, so we have 3 billion terms in the index, right? We have managed to squeeze it into 47 gigabytes, so it's still manageable on a modest computer. And for details, you can look recent papers of mine, and it's the homepage of the project is on this URL. It scales well. The response time is still under half a millisecond. The indexing takes place several hours. We went down from 23 hours to 9 with threading. And as it scales linearly, one can use parallel Lucene implementation when you seem that your query response time is too high, so it can easily be MapReduced and used by Google without problems. So here is the URL for the demo interface. You can go there, play with it, as I have already shown. And search using this 3 billion index. And the ideas I have already spoken about, we convert to presentation MathML with Tralix, but LaTeX ML or other converters might be used. We use UMCL library for canonicalization of MathML. We generate snippets containing the formulae, and we use MassJax on the web MIAS system for that. And it's already integrated in the UDML system, which is host demo is also already up and running on demo.udml.eu if you may give it a try. I have brought some brochures about the project and some of you have already took it. I also have here some papers if you want to get want to go into the details. So to sum up, for the content you should have the data, and our people in Birmingham are doing PDF to LaTeX converter. So from this we will have MathML for indexing, even from PDF where we do not have access to the sources. We have developed a copy paste package where the tech part of formula is put as a second layer in the PDF. So we suggest publishers use it so that it would be easier to index it with MAS in the future. Well, there are plenty of other things to do on our to-do list. It's worth mentioning that the approaches can be used even for content MathML. So in the case your data has content MathML, this might be a string inserted in the index as well and used in the searches, right? So it does depend on your preprocessing and the technology and framework allows for it. We may think of something like Sage to canonize the MathML before indexing, but that's another story. So we think we have done some steps towards the mass search engine for a community of mathematicians and perhaps also users of stuff you are typesetting. It's already employed and used in DML. I do have papers with details that were already published in Springlink and ACM doc DL in the recent docenc proceedings. Those who want preprints, I can give some. So that's not, I haven't done that work alone, of course. Most of the hard work was done by my students, Martin Liška and Michal Ružička. It was done within the funding of UDML project, and I owe a lot to the authors and contributors of tools used, and also Kaveh for permitting me to steal his title and part of his abstract. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Questions? Unusual. Boris has a question.
The problem with mathematics in tech is that it's extensible. In AMS, LaTeX can say in the beginning, declare math operator and create my own operator for my own operations. My question is, would your system understand this and just use a new op in the conversion and work?
The system works when you are able to convert it into MathML. So, it's easily enrich it. Currently, our Tralix is configured for full AMS LaTeX. It's easy to add new markup similarly as you add support for it for Tech for HT or whatever. So on this side, it's fine. It's harder to extend it in MathML. You may have wait for MathML 4 or whatever will support your new operators and the like. So once it ends in visually descriptive in visual, at least as visual appearance of your operators is capable to be described by MathML 3, percentage MathML, it will do. And given that the system configured for conversion from your tech markup, right?
Manjusha.
It's great to hear about it, but the examples which we have seen, it is about very small expression. What about complicated expressions? That is one thing. Another thing is about, you said it is all depend on what MathML, it is depend on MathML if it can convert the formula. But if you can look at the TeX file which is already having the mathematics in textual format, and most of the journals, they also ask for the TeX file. So if it is also possible to operate your thing on the TeX file and the mathematical formula which is available there. Is it, do you think so?
So first question, remind me the first one. Yeah. So one ArcSif article happened to be one big, really big formula. It started with dollar, and then all the text was the text, inline texts, and that was rather huge, and it generated a lot of sub-formulas, but, well, the system coped with it. On average, on ArcSif, we have for one formula about 20 to 30 index terms, so the ratio of 3 million to 158 million formula is about 30 or so. So the expansion is by 30, it's linear copable with, so I don't see any problem here. The second question was whether it's usable on the TeX files, right? Well, you mean the MathML is inside the TeX files, or no? Well, for that, you simply put your TeX as a query, and it gets converted to MathML, at least the mass chunk within dollars, and then you can search or index it. So we think that doing that on the TeX notation level, it's loss of time. It has been proven by latex search that it simply doesn't work. Mathematicians are saying they are not capable of searching, of finding anything there, because the differences in one place curly brackets or twice and spaces there and there, so you cannot search what are you can find what are you looking for. On the other hand, MathML we call with structure of the formulae, so that's much better.
Sorry. Hello. First, to sort of answer Boris's question, it's a tricky thing because, I mean, I'm talking about a slightly abstract level. The ability to present your LaTeX version with your own carefully constructed macros is actually part of the mathematical communication. So, MathML sort of ought to be capturing that, but if you think about the presentation MathML, it's not at all clear what you should, because you haven't got a macro language basically attached. But it's something that the MathML group is certainly very much aware of, and it becomes really interesting when you're trying to do open math content MathML, of course, because that's really where you do have that information from the author, and you either need to make it more explicit, as Peter suggested, or have some nice heuristics for guessing what's going on, sort of thing, if he's using tech input alone. But I just more general is just a comment really that as it was I think implying, and perhaps I'll make it a bit more explicit, this is actually the start of a well coordinated and very big project that could be of very great importance to publishers and everybody if it all works the way that some very respectable people want it to, shall we say.
Well, thank you. Well, I agree, and the converting from TeX to MAHML should take care of the peculiarities of authors markup, and these are scientific papers, so they are there should appear on paper. So on paper you should see the formula or commutative diagram. So this should be expressed in some way of in MAHML at the end of the day. So of course, authors are very creative, so they will come up and broke something, but they will not then be searched by this engine in possibly future MAHML. So it might be motivation for there to stick to known solutions.
This is kind of at the same level. As you say, authors are very inventive, and especially in new fields, they tend to invent new symbols or new terminology. And this is something that is not yet standardized, so the same concept could be represented by three or four different means. I guess the question is, how do we get authors to be more standard?
Well, the answer is, we are doing hard to reach critical mass so that mathematicians will then go, hopefully, into eudml.eu, as biologists are used to go to PubMed Central, and they are looking the scientific papers there, right? Who in biomedical domain, who is not in PubMed Central, as is if it's wasn't published, yeah. So, well, the dream is that UDML will become such established site, and then authors will be motivated to cope with the standards, as then their stuff will be searchable there and more accessible, and that would increase their page ranks, etc. So that might be incentive for authors to be more compliant.
One question we've gotten from some authors or other people is there somewhere a list of what symbols are used in which areas of mathematics? Does anyone know of such a resource? Math Society doesn't have any such thing and is not inclined to build one, but if one exists, I would love to know about it. So if anybody does know about such a thing, I'd be very appreciative.
Final quick comment and we have to move on.
Just a quick question to sort of counter Barbara as if she's listening. Ross? Thank you. I think my answer to that would be, do you think that math notation really has that property? We're not talking about physics notation here, remember? We're talking about math notation. That's an open question. I'm not... So, yeah, I think part of the reason why it doesn't exist is because math people don't think that way, if you like, or they use notation, as you know, in very strange ways.
Thank you very much, Petr.
Okay, thank you.